to bring inside AAC. Check out the matchup between the Netminders.
Braden Holtby gets the nod. His coach thinks his experience, puck handling ability can be an asset tonight. And his 931 career save percentage against the Canes ain't too shabby either. Freddie Anderson at the other end has been sensational. In his first 2 months as a Hurricane, he won 8 straight out of the gate and is 11-4 overall.
Familiar line starting things out. Jamie Benn remains at center. Nothing changes for the Stars, and why would you? He's between Raffel and Gurianov. Puck is dropped. We are underway from American Airlines Center. First of two this year between the Stars and the Canes. It's batted in. Hope he does drift behind the net to play it. Winds up in the corner, and right back, Miro Heiskanen. For Denis Gurianov. Jammed up along the wall, defensive zone. Heiskanen plucks it free and just eases it out to center ice. It's the Hurricanes with it. Jalen Chatfield, we told you about the COVID issues they're dealing with a couple of positive tests on the blue line yesterday. So two guys making their NHL season debut in Chatfield and Lajoie. Heiskanen cuts in, left side, he'll play it across the rink. Stall is there, canceled by Gurianov. It's out for Jacob Slavin. He'll hit the red line and softly feather in on the backhand. Jesper Faust around for Stahl. Centering feed clanked off of Hintz. And now it's Slavin. Floats one and off of Holtby to the corner. First on the scene is Joe Pavelski. Back-to-back big games for him. There's Roope Hintz. Quick shot through a defenseman's legs. Gets it back and he scores! This one, a buck 13 in, gets Dallas on the board.
Man, it is vaselinity and lethality in equal measure. He smoked that wrist shot originally, and just like in Arizona, he followed up a rebound, and this was a rather corpulent one off of Anderson. Gathers it in and rips it up top. Great speed down the wing. Use the defenseman as a screen. Shook some checking. And start the scoring.
It's a 5-game point streak for Roope Hintz. He opened the scoring 54 seconds in the last game in Glendale. It was a minute 12, courtesy of Pavelski, the last time the Stars were in this building. So another picture-perfect start for these Stars. It's becoming a regularity. It's the Hurricanes on the right side. Brendan Smith with a shot saved by Holtby. And eventually collected by Suter. He'll escape to center. Cross the line. Flips it rink wide. Behind the net, Radulov tried to drop it off in front. A couple teammates there couldn't connect. Sebastian Aho off the body of Klingberg. He'll move to Suter. Ahead, Joel Kiviranta. Down the left side, Kiviranta cut off by Chatfield, who then gets hit in the corner, hunted by Sagan. Kiviranta, loving down Glenn Denning, shovels the backhand off the stick of Sagan. Brady Shea of Carolina, trying to escape out. Holtby comes way out to the dot, hand off for Hakanpää. Now it's Martinook's shot, blocked by Sekera. Hakanpää and Sekera on this third pair for the Stars. Both have previously played for Carolina in their careers. Now a wrap by Lawrence. Shot, save made by Holtby. Got a lot on it. Holtby just protected.
Here's a look at, I don't know what happened to Andre Sekera there. Had his heels tied up a little bit. And wanted to get out and pressure this chance. You can see him look like a figure skater. And instead it was Holtby to the rescue. I think the stick blade might have been in the skate blade of his, and not only a great save by Holtby, but no rebound allows him to get settled. That was curious.
He looks to his left for the restart. Trocheck kicked out of the faceoff circle, so young 19-year-old Seth Jarvis wins the draw in relief. Cole with a shot is gloved by Holtby, and he will hang on.
or Taco Bell take tonight. The first goal, you're wondering how important it is. It's been big for the Stars to score first. However, the Canes have the best mark in the National Hockey League when allowing the first goal, as they have here tonight. They've won 7 of 9. Stars not so good when they allow the first.
Unfortunately for them, that's not an issue they've had to deal with often. They just are perpetually starting these games with a 1-0 lead now.
It's a nice way to live, man.
It's the Hurricanes. Shot from Slavin, scooped by Holtby. Again, no rebound. He holds.
Well, I'm sure Rick Bowness is tickled with the start from his team here again tonight. He had implored them to start better when they were struggling a little bit. And tonight is the big round number game for Bones. 2,500th NHL game, is 114th as the Stars head coach. Loves the one-on-one connection with players, always has. Said video is the biggest change that he's seen from when he began back in the 80s to now 2021. And man, they are so full of video. Coaches love it, players need it, crave it. It's a good thing, it keeps us employed.
Yeah, yeah. Big fan of video. He's a fun guy to talk to. He was asked all about it this morning and in the lead up to this game, and the passion, you wouldn't know it's been as long as it has been. It still feels like day one with his energy level. It's Hintz off of his skate to Pavelski. Guides to the circle, and a shot deflected before it could get on net.
There's such rapidity with Rope's game. Like, even when he stays onside, he does it fast and flashy.
I think Robertson is going to get a penalty here for closing his fist on the puck. You can glove it and just drop it at your feet. You can't hang on to it.
Dallas penalty number 21, 2 minutes for closing his hand on the puck.
It's rarely called, but you can see the Canes argue for it immediately as Robertson just took a little too long with it in his hand.
Well, most times you have to change the point of where the puck is with it. You close your hand and then move it to a different area. If you close your hand and drop it right there, you get away with it more times than not. You're right, that does not get called very often.
Stars' penalty kill is very much improved. We talked about their turnaround. That's a big reason why. 16 of their last 17 have been killed off over a five-game span. They control it here, and Hakanpää will send it the lane. Short-handed, Glendening's on it. Denied, and the rebound also turned aside by Anderson. Glendening in front, one more chance. And Anderson with a save.
And that was an elastic rebound off the end boards generated by Yanni Hakanpää, and the hustle of Glendening to get in there and test the Canes netminder not once but twice shorthanded.
Now the Canes are set up. There's a shot rimmed all the way around off target and back to the Carolina third.
Svechnikov can stimulate it. He likes to go what they call downhill from that left wing side. He's a left shot. Missed high and wide.
The guy to watch is Sebastian Aho. He is not on the ice right now. Or beg your pardon, he is on the back end. And Aho has 5 of their power play goals, far and away the team leader. Natchez carves across the blue line. He'll rim it around. And Aho does keep at the line. Behind the net, Ryan Suter with a blast, hit the body of Lajoie. And Natchez over to Aho. Lajoie, Natchez, triangle, missed Aho on the feed, and it's out to center.
I think it skipped on him, right over his blade. Break for the Stars, who are clearing the puck a lot with their penalty killing in recent weeks. They've moved up 6 spots in the ranking just in the last 14 days.
Another unclean entrance in the Stars shorthanded. Rope hits, has a step. He missed it up high. He protected away from the retreating Lajoie to get the shot away and just had it a few degrees too high over the bar.
Yeah, if he hits the net, it's 2-0.
Sagan picks the pocket of Niederreiter. Now Peterson, he darts in. Now to Sagan, and just missed him. Robertson's out of the box. He almost maybe thought keep him there with the way those 2 minutes went. That was almost all Dallas as it's out of play.
Well, they had the only 3 scoring chances during that Canes power play. You know, the turnover on their entry, and Rope full flight, tried to go a little lean and go against the grain, high blocker, and just got a little too much loft on that one and missed the net. Prior to that, the big bounce off the end boards. Anderson, I don't understand why he would not play that puck. I mean, you have to play that puck as the goaltender. Came out and almost cost them.
So 0 for 1 on the power play goes Carolina. There's a shot by Slavin wide. 5-on-5 hockey here. 1-0 Stars on the goal. 73 seconds in from Roope Hintz. Ian Cole chases it back. Radulov goes down at the edge of the trapezoid, laying on his side. He tried to just muscle it over to Kiviranta.
The one chance shorthanded we didn't go back to was Tyler Seguin wide open. If he could have picked up a few more miles per hour, Peterson laid it right in the general vicinity where nobody was going to get to it other than Seguin.
More pressure and a giveaway by Carolina. It deflects up and off the netting, out of play. 13:26 left in the first. Call it the third straight game where Dallas opens the scoring in the opening 2 minutes. It's Hintz again. 1-0 Stars.
We're up 1-0 early on the Hurricanes, and the 500th game played for goaltender Braden Holtby. Round number night at American Airlines Center. It's his 11th with the Stars. Put up dazzling numbers. Until Vasilevskiy last week, he was the second fastest to win 200 games in his career. Only guy ahead of him was Ken Dryden. You're on quite a list when the only guy ahead of you is Ken Dryden.
That was a buzz from a bunch of people just looking at the start he has put together in his career. You call it a start, he's a veteran, he's got all the hardware to show for it. Bounces back inside in the Carolina zone. Suter pressured by Niederreiter. Stars support back. Robertson flips it, looking for Hintz. He gets knocked down as he sent it in, and this is going to be a penalty against Carolina. Hintz taken down. Stars will go to the power play with a chance to double their lead.
Roope's been dinged up in his young career in plays along the boards like this. Cole came over. He was trying to go down low. It was almost like a unintentional slew foot on Hintz along the boards. And these Hurricanes are a club that'll take penalties. That's their 80th time shorthanded now this season. No team's been shorthanded more. Part of that, Josh, is the style they play. I mean, they are in your face. It's a great matchup. The number three power play against the number three penalty kill.
When you're going to take that many penalties, it helps when you can kill off 88% of them. Stars power play just red hot. They have power play goals in 10 of their last 12 games. They didn't score last time out in Arizona. They only had one opportunity. Those two games in that dozen where they haven't scored, each time it's been just a single opportunity. See what they do in chance number one here. Tripping against Cole, and Suter will have to track it back just inside his own zone.
Yeah, you're going to see teams start to try to avoid the Stars power play like a dirty diaper going forward here now, because it's so costly when you take penalties.
They'll have to work the entirety of the ice again. The handoff. Haskinen takes it from Holtby. Stretched it out for Hintz. He'll turn the Jets on. Down the left wing. Curl behind the net. And feed it up high to Suter. Back for Hintz. Across to Haskinen. Clanked off of his skates. It went right to Carolina. Shot in where Holtby will keep it moving on the backhand after turning aside Teravainen.
All that work to get in and get set up, and then there were better passes than putting it into the skates of even as talented as Haskinen is, he can't handle that.
Again, the Stars will have to touch up. About a third left on this power play as given away and cleared, and these two power play units haven't been able to do much with their first chances.
The Canes not as dangerous shorthanded as the Stars were, but
it's surprising they don't have a shorty this year. They ice it here to the Stars. Meanwhile, Sebastian Aho has more shorties than anyone over the last three seasons with 11. Fans, don't miss your chance to experience the excitement of Stars hockey with single game tickets from Ticketmaster. From marquee matchups to exciting theme nights, your seat is waiting for you at American Airlines Center. Visit DallasStars.com/tickets to purchase yours today.
Stars iced the puck here on this one. They came close to icing it earlier, and Gurianov beat out the icing. You shouldn't do that when you're up a man.
26 seconds left in the power play. Nate just went down on a knee to try to push it forward before the puck left the linesman's hand. So he gets kicked out. Stars win the draw against Boston relief.
Not allowed to do that.
Here's Robertson. Sees part for him, and a shot off the outside of the left post. That close to cashing in. There's a redirection, and Anderson with the save. Boy, not much happening for a minute and a half, and then it could look perfect in the box score.
Well, that's the thing. You only really need one chance.
Bad giveaway by the Stars, and then off the stick of Sagan, we return to 5-on-5 hockey. Lindell knocks off Martineau. Both teams 0-for-1. Score remains 1-0 Dallas. Robertson had the outside of the post pegged. Chatfield with a shot, slowed down and sent wide on a deflection block. Still inside the Dallas end. Martinuk will spin it in deep. Jesperi Kotkaniemi, former Montreal Canadian, signed to the one-year offer sheet in the offseason. That was a headline-grabbing move with a little revenge attached to it. Shot redirected in on Holpe. Secured the bouncer, hung for the whistle.
Well, the one chance they do generate on the power play is one of those wafty opportunities. After Klingberg sprung Robertson, he had options. I think he might have had Anderson the netminder thinking he was going to feed it off on the right wing side to Pavelski. Instead, that zip wrister off the pipe. You could hear how close Robertson came to making this 2-love. He's crafty, you know, he's lanky and he's crafty. Looks like he's going to do one thing, looks off some people. And when he does pull the trigger like that, man, that puck is moving.
It's Tyler Seguin on the faceoff opposite Vincent Trocheck. Trocheck wins it cleanly, turned his body, and then a wrister right into Holpe, who loves it for the whistle. As we check in downstairs with Michelle McMahon.
Josh, a goalie's best friend. That's the way that Braden Holtby describes his defenseman, Esa Lindell, who's not a flashy guy. He doesn't get a lot of the credit, but he does all the little things correct, and that usually goes unnoticed to the naked eye. The biggest thing that Holtby says stands out about him defensively is his body position and how strong he is on his stick. And he made it a point to give some love to a guy that flies under the radar too often.
It sure does, Michelle. Thanks very much. It's fun when players come to Dallas or personnel that aren't as familiar with the Stars and they're here for a month or so. You ask them about the team and it's always Lindell. Here's Peterson. He'll spin it right back through the slot. Cleared all the way down. This will grow some legs for icing.
Yeah, it's either new players coming in here or players and management that face the Dallas Stars in playoff series that see guys like Esa Lindell night in and night out, and they're like, didn't realize that guy was that kind of a defensive horse. He and Haskinen are forming a real prime duo for the Stars.
They are out there right now with the bend line for this offensive zone faceoff.
See what Trocheck does with this one. He won that one so clean from Sagan to set up the chance at the other end.
This time Ben wins it to Gurianov. Now back in the slot, shot stop, rebound. Ben was reaching for it, couldn't quite get it. Now Haskinen will have to chase back after Svechnikov. Svechnikov turns, protected away from Haskinen. Aho with a blast. And settled down by Ben. Gurianov doesn't have a stick. It was out to center, and Gurianov takes a fresh twig from the bench.
Sort of helped it along with the hand there out of the zone.
Anything he can at that point. Robertson, a chip. Hints, when he gets the legs moving through center, it just looks like he was propelled out of a cannon with the puck, without the puck. It's that burst that when he was hurt or recovering and you don't see it, it's noticeable because of how evident it is when all systems are go for number 24. Carolina, the turn from their own zone. It'll require a second from Natchez. Sagan just staying with them. And all Carolina can do is just push it ahead where the Stars grab inside their line. And it's up and into the benches out of play. With 8.5 remaining in the first period, it's the Stars on the strength of another early goal to have a 1-0 lead over the visiting Carolina Hurricanes.
2,500 games for Rick Bowness in the building. His team is the number one faceoff club in the league now. Every center iceman for the Stars is over 50%. Ben just won that faceoff against Vinny Trocheck, but Trocheck stuck to him like a shawl right to the net. They got in a battle, a jostle in front, and Trocheck got his stick in the general vicinity as Ben swung around and tried to make this a 2-0 lead for the Stars. Pretty good work by the two centers.
Kotkaniemi will shoot it in from center. Lawrence checked by Kiviranta. And Shea back around. A reach from Sekera. And out for Glendening. Pushed ahead. Tyler Sagan. He'll dart in. Sagan left it on the wall. Kiviranta went to the inside. And then Sekera stepped up on Lawrence. Kiviranta is chased all the way back behind his net. Pass right in the skates of Hakimpaa's, hard to handle. Becomes a turnover. Shot saved by Holtby on Shea's bid as he walked in from the line. Tyler Sagan. Chip it to the corner again. Kiviranta. This time he just lodges it against the baseboards in the corner.
Joel Kiviranta would like this shift to end right now, I think. Been a difficult one.
I don't think he's going to be able to press it long enough for the whistle. It's still tied up there. Niederreiter in as well. Niederreiter trying to turn. Poke check from Hakimpaa.
What's left of it in there?
He keeps bouncing out and then getting gobbled right back up. Almost like it's an orbital pull.
Yeah, penalty out of it.
And yeah.
More times than not.
So the Stars will touch and they wanted a whistle, but that's not what they wanted on the other end of it. Penalty against the Stars.
You know, they fight so hard for possession, and then if an elbow or a hand comes up or something. It all started though with a bad pass in behind. It was a weird spot. I mean usually you don't have a winger in behind the net with two D-men flanking you, and he sent it right into the big boots of Yanni Hakimpaa. And it'll be Kiviranta who finishes off that shift where he and Sagan got their signals crossed. And then the pass that moved in a hurry, and then a high stick that wasn't Kiviranta's. I think that was Brady Shea's stick that caught Kotkaniemi.
That's one of those strange scenarios where if there would have been blood on the play, they would have been able to review it. If it's a double minor or a major, you can review it anytime there's blood and friendly fire comes off the board. If it's a single 2-minute minor, you cannot do that. And so a break for Carolina.
Yeah, you can't do that, but the other officials on the ice can come in if they saw it and help out a little bit. And obviously nobody saw it. I mean, that was a mad scramble in the corner.
Offside against the Canes, then a little bit of a shove. Glendening and Svechnikov need separation.
And these guys saw each other a lot, and Glendening saw Svechnikov a lot last year too. With Detroit and Carolina were in the same division along with the Stars. Bonus knows after seeing it on the screen that it was a mistake. I don't know what the conversation is between officials. They're like, that's the way I saw it, I can't do anything about it. You guys were pretty good on your last penalty kill. Just move forward.
Dallas wins this faceoff. They'll clear it all the way down. The referees are Frederick Lequier and Corey Savret. Trent Knorr, Tyson Baker, the linesman. From center, it's Natchez. He'll drop it off. Trocheck, Teravainen. To the left side, Svechnikov shot, save made, Holtby, then it hit the body of Aho. Bumped around, Natchez will settle. He'll bank it up to the line, Teravainen. Back for Natchez. This is a 5-forward set on this power play for Carolina. They're without, again, three regular defensemen. Teravainen, Natchez, shot, save made. Holpe got just enough with the glove to send it wide.
I think he was visually inconvenienced in front of the net there. It was a tough stop.
Teravainen, top of the zone, and set to cross Aho. Drifts into the circle, low shot. Bounced right back to the near side boards. The Stars will take it away, and they'll clear.
Yeah, I mean, they're about mid-pack with their power play. You mentioned the guys they're missing that are available. Dougie Hamilton is now in New Jersey as well, and he was a humongous part of their power play in past.
Glove down, Lajoie, he'll shoot it in. Jordan Staal, who's out there, number 11, had a huge year on the power play last season against the Stars, 4 power play goals.
They seem to be looking for the same thing against Holpe. They put a man in front and then go low glove. And he got the first one with the glove. The second one, same thing. Looked past and got it on the short side. A lot of bodies to look past, though, for Braden.
The faceoff is controlled by the Canes. They don't have a lot of time left. Just 15 seconds remaining on Kiviranta's penalty. There's going to be another one against Ben as Kotkaniemi went down. I think they're going to take Kotkaniemi for embellishment along with Jamie Benn.
Well, he went like his spine got ripped out of him, so he was an invertebrate. Yeah, he's bringing them both.
Number 14, Dallas, minor penalty, hooking. Number 82, Carolina, minor penalty, embellishment.
They should change it from embellishment to charlatan.
You could call it that.
Yeah, and he looked, when the player goes down like that, Jamie, when the player goes down like that and the eyes immediately are looking for a guy in stripes, he knew what he was doing. The thing I don't like about it always and forever is if there was an embellishment on it, if he hadn't have gone down with as much gesticulation, there probably wouldn't have been a hooking call in the beginning, but instead they just sort of move along. Stars are without their captain for a bit, and Kotkaniemi sits and sin.
So it will remain a 5-on-4 for the next 11 seconds. That's how much is left in Kiviranta's high-sticking penalty. Face-off to the blocker side of Holpe. The Stars are a face-off win and a clearance away from getting through their second time shorthanded, but Pavelski's going to get ejected from the dot, and Raffel will move in. Against Lawrence, and it goes to the sidewall. Lawrence from the dot got to the wall first. Raffel just shoved down Faust, comes away with it. 3-on-2 rush Stars. Pass intended for Haskinen and knocked away. Kiviranta out of the box, 0-for-2, Carolina on the man advantage. Back to 5-on-5 hockey in the final 5 minutes of this opening period. Miro Haskinen. Scoot up ice. Get just across the blue line and drop it in deep. Cole starts the other way for Foss and then turned over to Klingberg in front of the Dallas bench. Clogged up in his skates. Pavelski moves the pile before stepping off to complete a change. Chatfield for Natchez. Natchez pass to the left. Tank behind the net to the near side. Aho takes for Natchez. Teravainen off his body. 3 Star sweaters there. It bumps loose. And an errant pass. Natchez was looking for Chatfield. He stepped inside. Puck went outside and it turned into a clearance.
The odd 5-on-5 should be 4-on-4 situation because of the overlapping penalty.
Yeah, they don't want to do that when you're already at a disadvantage one way or another, make it a 4-on-3. And so once the 2 minutes are up, you wait for a whistle, and that's when Ben and Kotkaniemi will be released. Brady Shea to the left point, shot goes wide. Peterson will scoop and skate down the left side, try to squeeze his way past Cole, who played it well. Cole hit by Hakanpää.
Hakanpää's been a load on those pinches like that. Very effective.
Alexander Radulov to Fox, a shot! Changed directions, went just wide of the left post. And Radulov spun it right back into the slot. Lindell gloves, keeps it in. Cole, a around for Teravainen, and he's got a man breaking, and Jarvis' pass was in his skates, and the teenager in the right spot just could not handle a very difficult pass.
He had position on Essa on the inside.
Here's Gurionov trying to split through a pair. He'll catch it up, bouncer on the end board. Slavin took it away. And then Kiviranta for Suter, through him, and Haskinen on the scene. Joel Kiviranta for Gurionov. Wristed in. Now it's Haskinen. And stepping down, Robertson kept it in the zone. It was almost a little hesitation for the forward at the point what to do. He wound up getting it. Andrei Svechnikov, the chip. Rope hints on it first. Banked off the stick of Pavelski. Ryan Suter. Hands ahead for Robertson. Now hints across the line, Pavelski. Pavelski, shot save made, and Robertson was searching for a rebound. Good job by Chatfield to get it to the perimeter. Star Steeler right back, Robertson looking for a centering feed for the forehand. Pavelski spun, and his backhand pass was intercepted.
It was well defended. I think it was Niederreiter, the forward, that ultimately broke it up.
Robertson. Flipped it back for Hakanpaa. Foss couldn't break it up because he was without a stick. Now it's Hintz, a shot! Short side, just missed it.
Fins are going off.
There are two sticks back in the Carolina zone. Now it's Glendening for Sekera. Shot low and just wide. Looks like a late Black Friday sale of hockey equipment inside. Carolina territory.
Sports down there.
There it is. Check the price on it. See if we can find a deal during the break. 1:27 left in the first. Rope hits the lone goal scorer in a 1-0 Stars lead.
Today, sunny outside, 55 degrees and competitive inside American Airlines Center, where Rod Brindamore's Carolina Hurricanes are out shooting the Stars, but trail 1-0. Captured the Jack Adams, our vote for Coach of the Year. I had him up top on my ballot. I told him on the way in, if I could have voted for him three times, I probably would have. Did a great job with them.
He gets so much out of his roster.
They are so him.
Yeah. A likable, hardworking guy. Social media shows pictures of him helping to unload on road trips from the plane to the bus. Done a terrific job with this roster. They are once again right up there near the top of NHL standings. But the Stars have the lead right now in the final minute of this opening period. Lawrence and Kotkaniemi angles it up for Cole, then back for Lawrence. A shot saved by Holtby. He controlled the rebound, got the glove down. What a tremendous first period for Braden Holtby.
Well, most of the action that he's seen has come from the outside. This is a tricky one. John Klingberg was trying to isolate against Lawrence, and for the most part, he was in good position. Just that long reach, perfectly married chance, and he chips it back between John's legs and in on Holtby. Scrambled across in that butterfly and stoned him.
Aho tried to do exactly what Trocheck did earlier to win a faceoff, but the false start cost him the opportunity. Ben wins it against Natchez in relief. Off the legs of Gurionov, falls for Foxy. He's got a streaking Ben. Ben in front, and Ben was tied up.
Wow.
And nothing called.
I thought I'd see an arm up for sure on that. The Stars transition game has blitzed them at times here tonight.
Chipped out to center, knocked out of midair by Lindell. Went right to Natchez. He had to deal with the body of Michael Roffel, who just stepped off the Stars bench. A dozen seconds left. Is it enough time for Dallas to do something? Here's Roffel, drag, spins, rolled off his tape. Natchez cleared it to center. Stars have to touch up. And that's how this first period will come to an end.
Well, don't get fooled by the shots on goal. The Stars played great in that opening period. Scored the only goal. They came close to getting on the power play again. Great isolation of Jamie striding it out. How that wasn't a penalty on the captain is beyond me. High stick on the hands. Stopped or thwarted a scoring opportunity. But instead, they'll head to the dressing room. Five aside. And the Stars up 1-0.
So the Stars on a night where Rick Bonus honored for his 2,500th game. Braden Holtby in his 500th. It's Roope Hintz who opens the scoring. 1:13 in. 1-0 Stars after one. And the intermission report is next. Tuesday night in Dallas, and the Stars have a 1-0 lead over the Carolina Hurricanes here at American Airlines Center with one period in the books. And we welcome you back inside. We started the night talking about Roope Hintz, and it didn't take long, Razor, for him in this game to once again showcase why he is so valuable.
Well, it's easy to foreshadow Roope right now, right? I mean, he gets in his stride immediately, and he's scoring early in games. Once again, he could have multiple goals after 20 minutes here tonight. Scored on his first shift of that opening period, following up his own shot. He's doing that a lot lately. He's skating exceptionally well, getting to the net repeatedly. And three good chances against Carolina in that opening period. You look back over the last three seasons, and Roope Hintz leads the Dallas Stars in goals per game. Haven't played them all, but in the games that he has played, he's scored an awful lot.
Let's head down for more on Hintz with Michelle McMahon.
Yeah, guys, just a quick bit. Razor did some investigative research on the hair situation that you drew some speculation on a couple of games ago, and he did say that the flow is coming back, which is certainly correlated with the goals being scored.
100%. We knew it all along. It was hockey's worst-kept secret. Good news. Imagine what that thing's going to look like late this season.
It's got kind of a one-length thing going on right now, and it's creeping its way down. Once it comes out of the back of the helmet, once again, we'll probably see multiple goal scoring games, you know, multiple goals within the game, maybe a Hattie. That one's sliding off the backside there.
Stars inside their own zone, try to get it to the line. Faust, he will keep in, stall the turnaround bid. And here's Raffel through center ice. He will chip it in, lose a glove, trying to jump around Cole in the process. So he just heads to complete a change, and it's stall the other way. Stall across the line, way offside on the far side. Offside against Carolina.
We also talked about Jordan Staal before the game tonight. He's a load on the forecheck. This is a hard forechecking team, and he blasted Miro Heiskanen on the end boards, but Miro pops up, gets to the front of the net, and as he does often, diligent defending against the forward, blocks that one, and away they go the other direction. Quite a young talent.
Sebastian Aho, Joe Pavelski. And the Stars win the faceoff. Klingberg stepped up by Shea. Shea back in the corner. And Robertson comes away with possession. Broken stick in the corner. Sebastian Aho grabs a fresh one from the bench. He was hoping it would be in rush with Carolina, but the Stars stole it back. Pavelski blows the tire. He'll head off. Fresh stick in hand for Aho as he tapped it in, but Klingberg first to it. And then stepping up was Natchez, hard on Foxy, trying to pick the pocket. Two Canes there against Klingberg, who softly played around the rim, and then getting tripped up Foxa. Radulov wins a race, so no icing. It hit the blade part of that broken stick. The shaft is going as well. Then it's Peterson who winds up nudging it along.
Shoved it right into the fray.
That thing just keeps making its way up ice.
I'm telling you, we have terrific audio in this building on our broadcast. That's the greatest audio of a broken stick I've ever heard in my life, though, when it snapped in the corner.
Here comes Carolina. Crossing the line, Trocheck couldn't thread one through Sekera, banked out to center, and then Svechnikov played it in where it's gloved down by Yanni Hakanpää. Hakanpää played 15 games last year for Carolina after coming over in a trade. Now Svechnikov to Jarvis. Bump back to Cole. In front, redirection, save, Holtby. He denied Trocheck point blank from the top of the crease.
And all alone, wow. Couldn't get to the rebound. There was an offering there, but what a stop again.
Lindell steps in front of Jarvis, leaves for Heiskanen. Glendening crossing the blue line, drop Kiviranta. Rink wide, caught a stick of Lawrence, and then almost the glove of Lindell. It's up and out of play.
There's been some physicality tonight. Svechnikov on the older bull, Radulov right at the Canes blue line. They go in transition the other way. Trocheck ended up all alone in front of the net. I mean, all alone. It was just Holtby against Trocheck. And Braden got out, stole a little bit of ice from him. It ricocheted off his stick. He could never dangle that rebound and get a second chance. Glittering goaltending from Holtby so far here tonight.
Stars control it. Here's Gurianov in front. His band pass couldn't get there. Then it's off the stick of Anderson.
Boy, this game's competitive on the puck everywhere.
Love down Kotkaniemi. Turns behind the net away from Lindell. Centering feed. Following up, it bounces. Then the reach by Holtby. Settled by Raffle. He'll cruise to center. Then he gets cut down by Kotkaniemi. It's back into the Dallas zone. No icing here. Lindell glancing at the pursuing traffic. Haskinen right through the Stars logo at center ice. Now into the offensive zone. Dropped it off in the corner, but White Sweater's there.
Just a race from the top of the circles to the top of the circles to begin this second period.
Almost 4 minutes of it gone by. 1-0 Stars have the lead on the goal that came very early in the hockey game from Hintz, just over a minute into the game. Icing whistled here against Dallas. Fans, from now through January 9th, bring your friends and family and skate under the stars at the outdoor ice rink located right outside Children's Health Star Center in Farmers Branch. The rink will host public skating and private events, plus there are concessions. You can visit DallasStars.com/public skating to learn more. Lajoie at the blue line. He'll keep it wide, funnel low. Stahl couldn't get around Pavelski. And cleared to center. A fumble by Lajoie. Hands it to Ben. He'll skate in. Niederreiter. Hit by Robertson. Edge of the trapezoid. Puck is pinned up there by the right boot of Niederreiter. And dislodged. Taken by Brendan Smith and lifted back to the star zone. Suter had the position on Faust. Dunberg around for Robertson. Taken by Carolina. Boss has a man in front, fed to Slavin, and it went right through him. And now Hintz on the counterattack. Hintz looking, had help, but he dropped it out of the reach of Pavelski, who got a shot away from the wide angle. Pavelski right back to Klingberg. That bid was blocked by Stahl. Suter a chip, Stars will change.
You know, it's easy from here. You just wish Rope had been a little more selfish on that break in rather than pass it off. With chances of both ends. Nobody has the puck for very long in this game right now. It is zipping around the rink.
Radulov. Bouncer along the wall. And then Cole. Back for Fox. Given away in the high slot. And the bouncer goes just wide. A changeup that was tough to deal with from Natchez. Cole holds at the line. Now Aho spun to Teravainen. Reverse check, knocked down Klingberg. Rattled around to the near side where Slavin activates. Down the wall, the Stars Fox up. Spun around and a penalty coming. Teravainen dropped the stick, is protesting the call, but he's going to go for 2 minutes.
Probably lobbying for the same thing the Stars got earlier on. That chance for Slavin right in front got jammed when the Stars were all out of sorts, trying to get out of their own zone. Talk about a ugly flutter puck. I think it might have gone off the glove of Radulov trying to help out Holtby and almost went in. The penalty is the stick got caught up. Guys hug onto it. Teravainen spun around. Foxa went down. Stars go to the power play. Their penalty killing has been excellent tonight. See if the power play can give them a little breathing room.
Stars are 0-for-1 on the man advantage. They have one shot. They win the faceoff. Klingberg at the blue line. Shot redirected by Radulov. He'll hustle after. Bump it to Hintz. Now Klingberg, top of the right circle, and a shot. The heels of Shea, kept in by Dallas. Radulov, Robertson let it go to Klingberg. Now it's his. Back for Klingberg. They'll fire it off the porch. Then Robertson put it right back through the slot. Klingberg again. This shot slowed down off a block. Smith, chance to clear, and he does.
That's as spread out as I think I've ever seen the Stars power play. I mean, they were way out on the outskirts. Had a lot of room to move the puck, but could never get anything into an area where it looked really dangerous.
Here's Klingberg back in. Hintz weaves. Turned over. He'll follow up and take it away after a failed clearance from Slavin. Robertson to Pavelski. Hintz wants it. Pavelski still has it. Goes low. Radulov double clutch. And missed Pavelski on the centering pass.
Late in that rotation and kind of a forced pass into the middle. A little more patience. They'd have kept control in the zone and re-attacked.
Power play and penalty killing units switch up. Here's Miro Heiskanen. He'll carry in. Flip it to Gurionov. Rim it around for Ben. And back across Gurionov. Heiskanen to Suter. Quickly Ben. Played off the wall. Jamie Benn has goals in five of his last 11 games. Behind the net, taken away and cleared by Slavin.
It's been tough to get some of their usual looks on the power play against the Canes penalty killing here tonight. And reminder, the third best in the NHL. And it's not by accident.
Basking in across the line. Now Sagan in the slot. Hard on the puck, trying to stay with it. He did, but was pestered too much by Lawrence. Out of the box comes Teravainen, 0 for 2 on the power play. Stars, though, still on the attack, 5 on 5. Slow moving to Suter, got the shot away, looking for a redirect, and Sagan just got past it.
Boy, Ryan Suter's so good at slipping that wrist shot from distance past shot blockers.
Here's Brady Shea, the defenseman is in, and a shot hung on to by Holtby. He'll secure it with just over 8 minutes gone by in a second period where the score hasn't changed. Still 1-0 Dallas over Carolina. First of two meetings this year.
Back from dealing with a lower body injury, third game if you include the brief cameo for Ottinger. He's been so tidy tonight. Seemed just fine. Seemed fine the other night in Arizona as far as that lower body soft tissue issue. It's been tested repeatedly here tonight. The margin for error is nil as the Stars lead the Hurricanes 1-0 as we approach mid-game here at American Airlines. And it's the ability to control rebounds that is a big, big plus.
Hockenbach up to the line. Chatfield kept it in, then got hit by Raffel. Center ice, Kotkaniemi retreating. In front of the Stars bench, swept near the center, and clanked away from Chatfield. Akinpah wrists it in. Horseshoe to the far wall, and then the Stars will rim it back around to the near side. Svechnikov didn't clear initially, following up Kotkaniemi. Good reach by Sekera. Onside comes Chatfield. He's bumped off. Came in with a lot of speed, picking up that puck.
Nice play by Andre Sekera. Not easy to steal that ice.
Stars take it away. Raffel trying to angle his way to center. He got played off by Slavin. Support Glendening quickly off Hockenpah's stick across to Sekera, but then hit Natchez. And crawled to the line. Good poke check by Hintz. He'll join the rush. Robertson. Hintz cutting to the net. A flipped pass there and just eluded him.
It's just like a go route all the time for Rope, you know. Just throw it into an area where he can scurry underneath of it and breach the defenses of the other side.
Hot pass. Winds up to Robertson. Fiercely sent around for Hintz. Behind the net, Robertson settles it down out of the reach of Pavelski. Kept by Hintz, Robertson. Star cycling and a shot blocked. Up and out of play. As we visit in with Michelle McMahon.
Yeah, guys, the captain had high praise for his coach, Rick Bowness, coaching in his 2,500th game here tonight. I asked Jamie what the best part about playing for a guy like Bones is. He said his passion for the game is on the highest level I've ever seen. He's an emotional coach and one you just want to win for. The best advice he's received from him, he says every day in the league is a privilege, and if you just put the work in and earn everything you want to achieve, eventually it will pay off. He's a player's coach. The guys love him. He's an unselfish man who cares the most, according to the captain. Guys.
Thanks, Michelle.
He's put Jamie out with Tyler Seguin. It was a new combination that last shift with Fox, Raffle, and Glenn Denning. Trying to get Tyler going, giving him a chance up the lineup here, get his offensive game.
It's been four games without a point for Seguin. That matches the longest stretch of the season for him. The other time it happened was the first four games of the year.
He's been playing under 18 minutes game, and you know, only the one shot over the previous three games. And look, they've been happy with the way things have gone. Every line has looked the same, killing. And this puck goes off a stick and on the plate. When they haven't had the puck, every line, every D pair is playing and checking the way they should. But it would be nice to get a few more guys involved offensively and feeling better about themselves, because look, there's many parts to everybody's game, and you're expected at this level and with this team to check and be responsible defensively. But you also get paid to put points on the board and score goals, and when you don't see those, I think it affects them overall.
Trio remains intact here. Niederreiter got it to the red line, and Klingberg gloved it there. Now it's Shea. Out for Niederreiter. Gordon Staal to work. Offensive zone for Carolina. Chatfield with a shot well wide. Shea off the skates of Klingberg. Right back to Shea, who has company at the half boards. Ian Gurionov cancel. Puck fought for in the corner. It's Staal pulling away. Wraparound chance off. Niederreiter still loose. Taken and cleared. And then Seguin got bumped into by Chatfield. He wanted an interference call.
Had a conversation with the ref. The ref is gesturing back.
He and Frederick Lecuyer from across the ice as Seguin went to the bench. Offside here against Carolina. 9:15 left in the second period. We have moved into the second half of the hockey game. Still just one goal. It belongs to the Stars. 1-0 Dallas.
Up 1-0 on the Carolina Hurricanes midway through the hockey game. Choctaw Casino and Resort Durant marquee matchup tonight. The second fiddles offensively, if you will. Andre Svechnikov and Joe Pavelski. Svechnikov has wrapped up the most penalty minutes on Carolina. Joe has scored the most power play goals for the Stars. There's a match.
Hawk and Bob behind the net. Now Brendan Smith steps down. Martinook and Lawrence. Could not crawl out from behind the end line. On the right side, here's Peterson. And now Hagenbosch streaks his way down the wall.
He's tough to miss when he pinches in. That's a lot of human coming down the boards.
Hagenbosch will make his way to the dots for an icing against Carolina. Fans, give the gift of hockey this holiday season with the Dallas Stars Holiday Hat Trick. Choose from three great plans and gift two tickets to three Stars home games, plus a special edition Stars winter hat, all starting at just $99. Shop now at DallasStars.com. It's Klingberg. Shot wide. Hintz was swinging, trying to redirect it. Missed him. Now Pavelski. Robertson in front, redirection, hands through his legs. Back was to the netminder, that would have been nifty.
He was as alone as Trocheck was at the other end. Kotkaniemi just left him.
It is the second half now of this hockey game with just over eight left in the second period. And the Stars have the 1-0 lead. The shots are 17-9 in favor of Carolina. You mentioned the first period was a little misleading because of all the perimeter work, The Stars would like to test Anderson a little bit more as this game moves along.
Well, they're generating nothing. I think that's why you saw the line augmentation from Bonus.
One-timer and Holtby tracked it well. Reaching and keeping Lajoie at the center of the blue line. And cleared out by the Stars, chipped by Robertson, gloved in a quick restart. Shea.
Aho can rip the puck, but that was a seam. Easy to see one-timer for Holtby.
Aho's got it here in his pass, just off target. He was looking for Lajoie.
In a lot of ways, the Canes are playing a very good road game here tonight. No surprise, they're an excellent team away from home.
9-2-1 this year outside of Carolina. In addition to having the best points percentage overall in the NHL, they have the best points percentage on the road. They play a lot of road games. They are in a stretch now where over a month's time, 15 of 20 games will be road games. The fact that they're banking points at the rate they are is really setting themselves up well for when it evens out. Glendening, centering feed for Gurianov. Glendening follows it up. It's Gurianov, Raffle, and Glendening out there right now.
Boy, a couple of very good defensive plays by Brady Shea in his own zone with that long reach. Been tough for the Stars to get interior and under control, and when they did, couldn't do anything with it. Hintz right in front.
Sagan and Ben hop out to join Gurianov. Now it's Shea. Up for Trocheck. He has a little bit of ice. Fumbled it twice, though, right to Sagan. Gurianov back for Sagan. He'll find Hockenpah down the right side. Shot easily into the glove for Anderson. He'll hang on to it there. Shade under six to play in the second period. 1-0 Stars.
Early goal standing up. Came close again. Good push down the boards by Ryan Suter. The Stars forecheck generates a wide open chance for him. I don't think Rope realized he was as alone as he was in front of Freddie Anderson, tried to deflect it home. And then the other direction, another Finn, Sebastian Aho, Seabass with the one-timer through a seam, and no problem whatsoever for Braden Holtby to get across and spit it aside.
Foxa and Stahl. Foxa wins it with the foot. Back to Klingberg. Shot, save, Anderson, rebound. And off to Faust. And Jesper Faust hits the red line and wrists it in from there. Faust plays it low. Klingberg turned, braced for contact from Stahl. Such a big body. Now moves to Slavin. Shot out to challenge. Blocked it furiously over the glass. Alexander Radulov.
Yeah, good, brave one. The stick died, paid a price. The Canes play a great orchestrated turnover game. They rip it around with somebody going there, send it back, get the defensive zone coverage, swimming a little bit on the forecheck, come up with the puck, stall against Klingberg on the end boards, and out goes Radulov to the top of the circle. In the lane, close the shin pads, shafted the stick in there, send it out of play.
Face-off win to Shea. That shot got through and just missed the far post. Lawrence has it knocked off his stick. Chatfield, a floater save. Holtby, rebound. Lingers for a moment. Haskinen scoops it up and able to bank it past Shea. Chatfield and Shea playing catch. Martinook landed off the body of the linesman and bounced back the other direction. Hustling after Pavelski has hits. Been there. Hits. Scores! Rope hits has both, and the Stars double their lead.
Forget about a goal a game, it's a goal a period. Little miscue on the dump, and Martinuk shoved it right into the linesman. They've got nowhere to go, and from that turnover, the Stars bust up the other direction. Joe Pavelski wets it for a second. Pretty pass to get it over to the left wing side, and Hintz loves to elevate. That's how you accumulate. Dagger over the blocker of Anderson. Two love Stars with five to go in the second.
Rope Hintz was getting all those chances at the beginning of the year, and it just seemed remarkable how it could be 11 games that he didn't score. After going goalless in the first 11, he's got 9 goals in his last 9 games. He is the Stars' leading scorer. He's got both in this. And after a period where they haven't generated much, all of a sudden they get some insurance. It's the Canes now on the attack. Nice move, Natchez, shot, save, Holtby, rebound, and the Stars will palm it down in the circle, bank ahead. Gurionov steps to the inside. He'll feed for Haskinen, back to Gurionov. When they've needed him to be, the Stars have had Braden Holtby perfect back between the pipes.
He's had a touch of luck involved in his game tonight, too, which you need. There have been some loose pucks on the flanks that Kane forwards have not been able to get to. That time it was Aho. He would have had a wide open net.
Final 4 minutes of the second period. Rafa will shoot it in. Anderson. Stars have pierced him 2 times now on the dozen shots, or I should say Roope Hintz has. Hockenbaugh will hustle, beat Svechnikov in the icing race.
Stars trying to exit their zone and again get forechecked and turned back. And from that, they get a great way to stick handling situation that was. And then the loose puck comes off to the side. It went off the heel of Jamie Benn's skate. Otherwise, it would have been Esa Lindell in net instead of Holtby.
Hintz's goal assisted by Pavelski and Robertson. So all 3 guys on the line chip in. It is the 3rd straight multi-point game for Joe Pavelski after he did not have one through the first 17 games of the season.
Nobody's been able to control that line, road or home.
In comes Trocheck. Shot saved by Holtby, way out. Another one! And he gobbled it up on the bid from Jarvis.
That's multitasking. What a flashy pass by Svechnikov to send them on the trot. Stops the first run. He's out telescoping. Gave up a bit of a fat rebound on it and answers the kid right after that. Jarvis kept his poise. They can skate on their knees. That's a great stop. Jarvis has been an interesting story for them. Coming out of the Portland Winterhawks and still a teenager.
13th overall pick in 2020. Weren't sure if he was going to spend the entire year up in the NHL. He kept impressing, so he played double-digit games. It means it burns a year of his entry-level contract, and he's a Cane for the season, no doubt. Up top, here's Smith to the left side. Lajoie, and a shot. Missed the mark, short side.
It's like the Hurricanes have had more of the sustained pressure in the East-West game on the Stars. They try to dump it in. And the Stars have had these darts up the ice that have been very dangerous. It's like rush chances, and Roope's the best at it on the Stars against forechecking chances. And they've turned the Stars back a little bit here in the second period and generated scoring opportunities from that.
There is, off the faceoff, a quick whistle. Come back and do it again.
The referee was really gesturing a lot.
I think he was kicking Koke and the Emmy out of the dot.
I don't know that he can do that.
That was almost the signal you make when there's too many
men.
Yeah,
that's what I was thinking. It's like, there's no way they had too many men on the ice. Everybody was standing still.
So after that, play goes on. Fought for in front of the appropriately vacant penalty boxes. Andrei Sekera pursued by Koke and the Emmy. And then a bounce pass Smith from across the ice, Lajoie. Lajoie, one-time Ottawa Senator. Hasn't played in the NHL in a few seasons, forced into duty with the mini COVID outbreak to the Carolina Blue Line. Cut off at center, Lawrence. They'll bump it in, and Hockenbaugh back to chase again. And Lawrence, big man himself, came right up and collided with Hockenbaugh.
There have been some collisions in the game. feisty battles for the puck along the outskirts of the rink.
Approaching the final 100 seconds of this second period. Stars have one in the first, one in the second. Both from Roope Hintz. Cut off by Kiviranta. Way offside was Raffel. He had to touch up. The Stars still have not touched up. So when they touch the puck, it's blown down.
Raffel got his rails all the way out or not on that one. It's play smart time now, right? The refrain on the Stars bench be about score and time. You're up by two. Don't do anything dumb. And, you know, turn pucks over when you don't have to. Take a penalty that you don't need to. With a minute and a half to go, take a 2-0 lead to the intermission and see whether this Canes team can chase you down in the third period on your home ice.
For Carolina, it's another night now where they've had trouble piercing the opposing net, and they have such a strong record, but their last five games, the wins and the losses tell a vastly different story. There's Radulov trying to center it. Staying with it as well, Foxa. Up the boards, Canes have possession. Up for Shea, and then Natchez falling down, sweeps it in. The last two wins, Carolina has scored 11 combined goals. In their last three losses, they've scored four combined goals. It has been feast or famine for the Canes. Here's Peterson trying to split, nice move around Chatfield, tried to do it again inside, and Chatfield played him off. Teravainen poked off his stick, kept in the zone. Natchez. Aho, a shot off the glove of Holpe and then the glove of Radulov.
Holpe had no idea where that went after he made the save. Radulov did.
Final half minute here of the period. Not cleared. Slavin kept it in on Robertson's bit. Slavin down into the corner. Now up top, Teravainen. Quickly moved. Shot blocked. Set wide. Miro Heiskanen leads the counterattack, hits the red line, played to the corner, Stars at the tail end of a shift. Just 10 seconds left in the period. Slavin glances at the clock, not a lot of urgency. Ahead for Jarvis. He'll cut across the line and will not get a shot away.
Some lyrical skating to end the period down the left wing boards. Stars took on a little water as the second period went. Radulov was terrific in his own zone. Big block shot. Picked this one out of midair. Holpe was looking over his shoulder. Where'd that go? And he took care of business. So a clean sheet through 40 minutes from his perspective. The Stars are going to have to play with the puck a little bit more, you would think, in the third period. They can't play on their heels for 40 minutes and expect to win this hockey game.
It was a nice tap by Holpe for Radulov on their way back to the locker room. He stopped 23 of 23. Roope Hintz has delivered all the offense Dallas has needed so far. It's 2-0 Stars over the Canes, 40 minutes in the books. Second intermission report comes your way right after this. We welcome you back for the start of the third period. We told you earlier about the milestone evening for Rick Bowness, coaching in his 2,500th career NHL game. Nobody's ever come close to that mark. It started almost 38 years ago to the day, Razor, back in November of 1983.
You know, I'm just so glad that he's embracing it here tonight instead of just, you know, he has the family here. He talked glowingly this morning about his journey from the 80s on into 2021. Of course, the true dean of bench bosses is the feature of tonight's Blue Cross Blue Shield Legends of the Game. It's Scotty Bowman. 2,141 games as a head coach, started at age 34 in St. Louis, finished at 68 with Detroit, won 9 cups along the way, never took the helm of many sort of rebuilding clubs in his illustrious Hall of Fame career.
Now the Stars under Rick Bowness have built themselves a multi-goal lead, going for the finish here. Have a 2-0 advantage. Roope Hintz has both of them. One in the first early, one in the second. Stars had to absorb some good chances from Carolina in that middle frame. Let's see what the third period offers. As Raffel down the right side against Slavin. Inadvertently, the referee turned into a bit of a pick. And then spent back around where Aho can clear. Ryan Suter. The wide turn finds Klingberg. No room for him to shake around Natchez. To Joe Pavelski, another big night for him. That started to become a norm. Svechnikov to center, hopping on it, Aho, Natchez. Good reach by Klingberg to knock it away at the line.
There's a good gap. You know, your D are going to stay up like that and break up plays if forwards are conscious of coming back and helping out defensively, and they have it. Stars have bent a little bit in the game here tonight, but they're real proud of their game right now where they bend but don't break.
Certainly was the case against Arizona in their most recent win on this four-game winning streak. Box of chips, Chatfield drops, Lajoie. Two guys recalled from the American Hockey League out there right now. One of the stories is how Carolina was going to divvy up their ice time, because with the three defensemen they have out, it's three of what is normally their top 5 minute getters on the blue line as it's whistled down at the line.
It's kind of similar with Rod Brind'Amour is dealing with what Dave Tippett had to deal with when Edmonton was in here, and they were missing their entire left side at game's end when Duncan Keith got injured in game. But no Pesci, no D'Angelo has been terrific for them, and Ethan Bear, the former Oiler, all out of the lineup. They're dealing with COVID. Who knows what else is going on? They all got tested here this morning again because that stayed away from media. They hunkered down in their hotel last night, couldn't leave their rooms. Everybody knows about that around the NHL from the last season.
It's different this year, but two teams have already been shut down because of COVID outbreak in Ottawa and then most recently the New York Islanders. Andre Sekera played around for Radulov, chipped, falls for Pavelski. Kotkaniemi caught him. Lajoie shoots it back in. Chatfield. Low shot saved by Holtby. 23 of 23 through the first two periods. Martinuk a drive. Save. Holtby. It fell in the crease, and he got the glove down as Chatfield went hard after what was a momentary loose puck before it was covered up again.
To whether he fell down or not, if he went in there intently with his skates first, it's a deranged little play. Holtby got his glove on this puck and melted it down. I got knocked off his rails a little bit by Alexander Radulov, who's been diligent defensively tonight. You know, Holtby in that second period had to scramble a lot. There were a lot of scramble plays in and around the net, and his agility was on point. First period, a lot of stuff came from distance, and he handled that. Been busier and more difficult as this game has moved along.
Off win by the Stars back in their defensive zone. Dallas has the advantage in the faceoff circle. 24 to 18 in the game. Ben pulls away. Dumped in from the center line. Sagan going to work. Shoulders off Cole. And then Suter stepped down. Bumped down Faust as it danced the dasher. Stretch pass up ahead. A good reach by Kiviranta as Jordan Staal had a step behind everyone in green. Staal gets it back. Captain for Carolina. Now Lawrence. Net drive rolled off his stick. Tyler Seguin will just chip it off the glass. Wholesale change for the Stars as the Canes re-enter. Riddell gets shoved by Staal. Now off of Roffle. It's kept in shape. Foss pass. Bank to Staal. He will move it to Smith in a drive redirection, and it falls and stays in play. I think everybody at ice level lost sight of that puck after it deflected between the circles.
They waved off his icing, and here comes Aho.
Gaining speed, feeding Natchez. Down the right side, Natchez's shot saved by Holtby. Rebound lingered for a moment, then cleared out. And Rope Hintz streaking after. Hintz has both goals in the game. It's his sixth career two-goal game. He has never had a hat trick. Pavelski to Heiskanen. Shot goes wide. Hintz behind the net. A wraparound stays with it. And now Lindell's shot saved by Anderson. Robertson goes to Pavelski. Centering feed off of Robertson. Hustles to get it back on the wing. And he gets moved off the puck. Lindell has to turn back and chase. He lobs it in. He was on the wrong side of the red line, and it's icing. The Stars at the tail end of a shift were going to change. They cannot, and they've got some tired bodies.
They gave up a rush chance, I think, when a lot of the Stars thought it was going to be icing and had to scramble back out there again. And Miro Heiskanen spies Aho, doesn't get transfixed by where the puck is, takes the man away from the puck, and erases another scoring chance for the man they call Seabass. Seabass isn't actually bass, by the way. Chilean Seabass is actually Patagonian toothfish.
Shot saved by Holtby, and the rebound goes just wide of the post. Heiskanen with Trocheck halfway up his jersey. Now it's in the dot. Swept away before Lindell could calm it. Jarvis banks it near side. Chatfield, an errant pass to Lajoie, will do the Stars a favor. Carolina has to touch up.
Stars will get some of their change in. Heiskanen's been out here for a long time.
He and Lindell closing in on 2 minutes this shift. They still can't get off yet. Now Peterson gets it across the red line, and the D can change for Dallas.
The two fill-ins on defense for Carolina have actually played well in the game tonight. They haven't had too many issues.
Here's Chatfield turning on Foxa. Good support from Sekera, and then the net comes off its pegs as Hakanpää blew a tire, went right into his own netminder, and took both sides of the net off.
I hate seeing stuff like that, because the player, whether it's a goaltender or a player, are not prepared for that. They're not bracing for it. On his knees, and thank goodness the nets blow off those pegs. Hakanpää wore 58 for Carolina. Dropped down to the towering number two in Dallas.
I think they only make that jersey one size
in
Dallas.
Yeah, they did. 6'5" and up.
He'll stay out there. Glenn Denning with the faceoff against Martinook. Blocker side of Holtby, and Hakanpää controls to Sekera. All the way down, no ice. Jacob Slavin, he rings it the length, and icing waved off again.
Well, because of the pinching defenseman, you had it on both blue lines, and when they do that, they usually wave it off.
Now it's Cole, pursued by Kiviranta. Nino Niederreiter, it's chipped from the red line. Sekera, reach Gurionov, kept in, and a turnaround shot. Martinook ramped off a stick and out of play. Fans, keep up with all the action by following the Stars on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook for the latest team news, score updates, contests, and exclusive behind-the-scenes content. And for more must-see Stars videos, don't forget to follow us on TikTok.
You can see this full forecheck press from Rod Brind'Amour's Canes right now. If the Stars can get through it, they should have gobs of ice off ice if they can get through it clean.
Klingberg partially fanned on his outlet. Got it up ahead. Raffle. The Canes at center. Suter broke it up, intended for Stahl, and Brendan Smith off of Lawrence. The chase, and Suter steps in front of it. Bounced out to neutral ice. Ben knocked down at center as he was spinning. Captain on captain collision. Now it's Foss from a knee. A save made by Holtby. And Ben will clear.
Kind of jammed himself a little bit by not handling that puck clean on the entry. And a repelled puck off the chest of Holtby. It's risk-reward in this game right now, though, isn't it? You can just sense it. And icing here again. And can't change on the Stars' perspective. Rick Bonus has thrown out and put a real premium on faceoffs in his own zone. He's had Pavelski out there for some draws, and then he changes. Jamie Benn's been out for some draws, then he changes. They can't change at all here. Both of them are on the ice. Shouldn't be a problem.
Pavelski on this one against Aho. Both men tumble down to their knees. It's the Canes who control it. Svechnikov from the near side, angled across. Slavin with a shot blasted wide. Suter has body position on Svechnikov. They tie up. Natchez keeps it in the zone. Banned on his bid. Second effort funneled low. It's Sebastian Aho. Some dangerous Hurricanes out there right now. Slip pass intended, intercepted Suter. Colin Robertson and Pavelski able to chip it to neutral.
Good strong work by Robertson on the boards after some stylish swerving from Suter down deep.
Robertson gloves, didn't panic on the backhand, turned to his forehand, muscled it the length. Stars can get fresh legs.
Cole had no choice but to play that one. It looked like it was going to be icing, and it came right to him.
Take away Peterson. He'll carry it in. Jacob Peterson left side. Centering feed off of Radulov. Haskin in down the right wing. Pickpocket on Cole. Back for Peterson. Peterson scored in the last game against Arizona. Now it's Lindell. As Carolina is changing, it gives the Stars open ice. Anderson the netminder, giving away to Radulov. He braces for impact, protects the puck. His second collision knocks him off of it. Devo Teravainen on the right side. Jarvis in front. Redirection scooped by Holtby. He snags it. Secures with under 12 minutes to play in regulation. 29 shots have gone his way. Holtby's made 29 saves.
The New York Rangers up top with a half a dozen each. Robertson with five, two of those this year. He's got that knack. They're rocking it in here right now.
Wait till the next one, right?
The Stars are trying to hang on to a Roope Hintz 2-0 lead, leaning heavily on Braden Holtby in the pipes tonight.
I think they got friends in low places in the queue ready to go. Here's Chatfield up high. Jarvis's shot gets blocked. Racing after it. Haskin in. Swept near the line and just pushed across it. Luke Glendening. Tyler Seguin. Seguin, Glendening, and Kiviranta. There's a trio out there at the moment. Seguin, nice job, works it free. He'll have a shooting angle, played it to Kiviranta. Now back for Seguin. He gets cut off by Lajoie. Teravainen out near the blue line and across it. Kiviranta spun it right to Teravainen. Andre Segura. Pass Kiviranta, stopped by Cole. Stays in Dallas territory, but Hakanpaa collects. Soft chip, Glendening. Stolen away at the red line and then given away right back to Dallas. 10:45 and counting left in the third period. Stars with a 2-0 lead. These two teams met eight times last year. They'll just be right back to the East-West couple this season. This is the only time in Dallas. Robertson is shot, and it scores! It deflected off the post. Pavelski the flyby. And it's 3-0 Stars.
He's interrupted the Roope Hintz scoring in the game tonight. Pavelski beats his man off the boards. Cole, he just rocks him, gets to the front of the net. And that quick snapshot from the blue line hits the pipe. I don't think it's going to be Pavelski's. I think it hit the post and then hit the back of Freddie Anderson. He celebrated like he got a piece of it. A tough shift for Cole and Slavin, who barely left the ice tonight. And they have no answer, as many have had no answer for Pavelski, Robertson, and Hintz.
Yeah, if it's Pavelski's, it was on the tip beforehand, because after it hit the post, it hit nothing other than Anderson's arm and inadvertently into his own net. Regardless of who gets credit with it, it is now one goal in all three periods and a mammoth tally.
Yeah, that's a big one with half a period to go now. Forechecking, quick snapshot by Robertson. Yeah, he did get... You can usually tell from the degree of celebration from a player, and after it went in, it's the punch of the air tells you, yes, I got a piece of that.
That line is absolutely on fire. Joe Pavelski will get credit for it. His seventh goal of the year, his third point of the game. Holtby seals off the post at the other end. It's now 7 points in three games for Joe Pavelski, last year's leading scorer. Lawrence, the chip off the body of Radula. And if it felt like there is a push coming and maybe an inevitable additional surge, no pun intended, coming from the Canes, that one just provides a mountain in front of the visiting Carolina Hurricanes. Scooped up by Holtby, he'll hang on to it. His sheet is perfect. At the other end, the Stars have now pierced Anderson. In all three periods, Pavelski the latest. It's a 3-0 game.
Tom McMahon here with you. It's time now for our Chevy Under the Hood. And tonight, it's Ryan Suter, the elderly estatement of the group. He says that 36 is old, though. His favorite food before game, bread, oil, and Parmesan. Interesting choice there. Big carbo load guy. Favorite movie, Shawshank Redemption. And if it wasn't for hockey, what job would he have, you ask? A Zamboni driver. Classic, guys.
It's a good pick on the movie. Tough one to beat. Stars are writing a script that they have seen an awful lot here tonight. Entered with a 4-game winning streak, 5-game home ice winning streak. And the recipe has just been very similar. They score first, they never trail. That's been the case thus far. Here's a shot saved by Holtby. Aho didn't get nearly what he wanted on.
No, he's their leading goal scorer and point getter, and he's had some opportunities tonight, but most of them have been of the Muff horizon version. The one-timer was probably the hardest one, but he didn't elevate that. Didn't get much on this opportunity. He's quite a talent. Great vision, intellect, as good a playmaker as he is a goal scorer, but the Stars defense and Holtby have kept him silent tonight.
9 minutes exactly remains on the clock. Defensive zone faceoff for the Stars. It wasn't clean. They're going to kick Glendening out of it, so enter Tyler Seguin.
They got so many guys that can win important draws on, you know, both sides of the ice in their own zone.
On cue, Seguin in relief. Another game where the Stars have opened up a large advantage in that category. 30-21 now, favoring Denver. Yanni Hakanpää uses the larger frame to field off Niederreiter and uses the glass, got it to the point. Follow-up Seguin didn't clear, comes right back to him. Softly to Sekera, he lost in his skates on the wall. That creates a battle for possession. It's won by the Canes. Slavin into the glove of Holtby, who holds.
So Joe Pavelski, the ageless one, is on another one of these runs. He's seen his time on ice drop from a forward leading 19 minutes last season, where he also led the Stars in scoring, to about 16 and a half minutes this year, as they've spread it around, healthier club and all that, but doing the same thing he was doing last year. You know, 3- and 4-point nights were, I'm not gonna say commonplace, but there were a lot of them.
All started with that bubble restart in the playoffs. He's now in his third regular season. You lose track of time with the pauses and the restarts. He has just been such a contributor ever since that postseason. Jamie Benn gets it through Smith, ran him over in the process, and then he protected the puck, but he took it up high. Benn went down, gets up as quickly as he can, but that one stung him.
Yeah, Brady Shea looked concerned there immediately, and Jamie scurries off in a hurry, took it right in the lips and chin. It's a hairy chin. And he's gonna have to go for some repairs with 8 minutes to go in regulation. So that messes up some of Bone's ability to throw him out there for faceoffs down the stretch.
He's one of the very few players that is grandfathered in where he doesn't wear the half shield visor. That puck, I don't think, would have hit the visor
him.
Even if he had it. Here's Chatfield. And softly dumps it in. Tinbert takes it away from Trocheck. Nicely just poked around. Jarvis reversed by Radulov. In the corner, Jarvis tripped up Teravainen. Back to the line. Floated shot redirected. And Klingberg to the near side. Trocheck. Radulov angles it out. Nice touch on it. It wobbles. Not nearly enough for icing. Fresh legs on both sides as the clock, very much a friend of Dallas, continues to tick away.
Jamie Benn just made his way back to the starter's bench, so some ringside triage.
That's quick repairs.
Well, Dave Zeiss is incredible. Just stop the bleeding. Let's have a look. Oh, yeah, sure. A little luscious groovy going on. An interior laceration.
Tyler Seguin is out there with Glenn Denning and Kiviranta. Glenn Denning on the draw against Stahl. And it's the Hurricanes who come away with it. Brendan Smith chips it. Hockenpah gloves it down. Sekera, Fost, offside are the Canes, and they'll touch it across the line.
Well, the Stars really do have a recipe for success going right now. I mean, you get near heart, hermetic netminding, and then you have a line that nobody has an answer for right now. And, you know, since Joe Pavelski became a Dallas Star, when you look at the points per game, on this team, it goes Robertson, Hintz, Pavelski. They're in their third season. Two for Robertson. They did some damage last year, and they're doing it again this season.
Tonight, every point in the game exclusively belongs to that line. They've combined for all three goals and 7 points. Aho. And now Raffel. Rolls away from Ben, who's right back out there. Natchez is tripped up by Gurianov. So a late penalty is going to go against the Stars. Anderson slowly to the bench. And Anderson never makes it to the bench. It's Gurianov who touches it.
You know, and immediately everyone's attention goes to, really? You're going to make the guy earn the goose egg in game number 500? Like this, that is the old can opener there, and a tight squeeze there. That's the old thigh master on that one at the blue line to put Gurianov detained. Kane's power play on the job here again, and the Stars desperately wanting to preserve the seal at the end of their rink.
Tripping against Gurianov, third power play of the game for Carolina. They are 0-for-2. Both teams 0-for-2 on the man advantage. Carolina has two shots on their power plays. Svechnikov up and down the near side boards. Bank Teravainen. Now Svechnikov. Across. Shot. And through the crease and wide. Teravainen is pressured. Flipped it. Aho. One-timer. That one blasted wide. Svechnikov. Feeds it up to Teravainen. Now back for Svechnikov. Reached by Foxa. Deflected it. He follows it. Stays in the zone. A chance to clear Hockenpah, Lindell, and they do.
A great read, reach, break up that cross ice pass. They got a lot of guys who can make plays under duress on their power play.
Trocheck takes the feed. He'll carry in. Rim it around. Jumped on Aho. Hintz is out there. Had a terrific shorthanded chance back in the first. Now stripped away in the Stars. Shorthanded do race. Lindell to Hintz. Shorthanded for the hat trick. And he handed it off to the trailer. Raffel never got the connection.
Nobody wants Rope to ever pass again tonight. Ever. As he guns for his third.
Aho. Lajoie. Baines back in. Natchez, tough pass. Lajoie, and then just cleared by Raffle, tail end of his penalty-killing shift.
I mean, he's had a couple of real good quality stares at Anderson to get the third tonight, and he's passed.
Lajoie has to hold up while the Canes touch up. Jarvis the turn at center, and then he gave it away, Pavelski. No numbers. Pavelski didn't have any help, so he just dumps it in. And another power play comes and goes very quietly for Carolina.
Well, tonight the Stars have had the better scoring chances on their power plays
by a pretty significant margin.
And high quality.
Yeah. It's played with a high stick back in the Dallas zone. A second under 4 minutes remaining in the third period, and Dallas has a 3-0 lead. Been playing, but it has been a perfect decision as this game is played on.
Yeah, Jake put up excellent numbers against the Canes in the season series last year, and he's been nearly unbeatable since coming up from the American Hockey League. He's played all his games in this building, but should never lose your starting role to an injury. So as soon as Holtby was healthy, back in there, and brilliant here tonight.
4 minutes remaining in it. Face-off win by the Canes. Netminder Anderson stays put at the other end of the ice between the pipes. Down the left side, across for Cole. Shot off the post, and it somehow stays out. Where is it? It is fought for. It's at the side of the cage. Holtby's facing the wrong way. It's loose. Holtby got the pad over, and then it's in the net. What a sequence. And after the incredible scramble that went from behind the net to in front of it, with 3:33 left, the shutout is broken.
Man, oh man, what a stand it was for Holtby and everyone in green. The initial one, you could hear how close they came. Full contortion from Braden and company to try to keep it out, but they could never gather it in. They worked around the stump. They plowed around it, and ultimately Kotkaniemi was able to deflect the puck toward the net, and some way, somehow, they hacked, whacked, and bludgeoned it over the goal line, through Holtby, who had lost his stick. Snow Angel, shutout bit gone. And a little more drama pumped into the game here with 3.5 minutes to go.
It's the sixth goal of the year for Jesperi Kotkaniemi. He's got goals in three straight now after a bit of a tough start. He came over in that publicized one-year deal on the offer sheet for Montreal. Stars take it away here. Anderson was starting to beeline to the bench. He scurries back. Boy, as that puck stayed out, as the scramble continued on, you wondered if the hockey gods were just going to carry Braden Holtby across the finish line in game number 500. Natchez passes to the left side. Now the net is empty. Hintz takes it away for the hat trick. He scores! First career hat trick for Roope Hintz. Puts this one away.
It's a blemish for the Stars' defensive game, and Holtby in particular surrendering the goal, but it's a gash offensively tonight from number 24. Roope gathers and a bullseye from just inside his blue line to send some hats down to ice level. And what is it about the Carolina Hurricanes? The last time the Stars registered a hat trick, period, in regulation and regular season was February 11th of 2020, and it was Jamie Benn in this building against Carolina. His first two, the conventional manner, sipped the second one past Mrazek. His third, into an empty net, struggled to get it, eventually was awarded as he got dragged down. And it was a, I think it was military appreciation night, and there were camouflage hats that everyone was given, and they rained down that night. Jamie put one on the bench in celebration, but how about that for bookends? And good on Hintz. If anybody deserved to get the HT, as the kids call it now, or the Hattie for the Dallas Stars, it's Roope Hintz.
He is up to 10 goals now on the season, leading the Stars, number 8, 9, and 10 in this one.
This is going to look like a bizarre game on the stat sheet at the end of the night, though, isn't it?
Yeah, and if you've been with us, you know, as the game went along, Carolina started to get more and more quality opportunities. They basically had a shot advantage the entire game, even though the Stars played an exceptional first period. Holtby was outstanding. The one goal they did get was still just unbelievable. Radulov blocks a shot. Anderson back between the pipes. 2.5 minutes to go, and the white flag probably coming up at this point. There's a shot left circle, goes wide. Radulov reverses back for Klingberg. Another game where the Stars land a punch offensively, suppress one from the opponent defensively. It has just been really lather, rinse, repeat during this home streak where they're about to win their sixth in a row here at American Airlines. Miro Heiskanen is pinned up. Lawrence to the point. Stahl wraparound saved by Holtby. They're approaching 40 shots as it's clear. Icing almost reluctantly, like nobody wanted to hit the dot for sure.
Our car shield protection play of the night is again plural, and it's the performance in the pipes from Braden Holtby. An eyelash away from blanking the Carolina Hurricanes here tonight, but they don't build the lead they built without him repelling as many pucks as he has tonight. They're closing in on 40 here, and he's a prolific sweater. Gone through gallons of water, I suspect, tonight.
Ruffle on the forecheck as the Stars is trying to finish against what Rick Bonus called one of the hardest working teams, if not the hardest working in the NHL. Here's Svechnikov coming free, and a save! Rebound, another save! And another save! You've got to be kidding! Braden Holtby, take a bow in game 500.
This is absolute multi-larceny. Grand larceny! Grand larceny! Take your pick! Bang! No! Denied! Svechnikov! Unbelievable performance from Holtby, who gets to 40 shots faced in that flurry.
That's a season-long highlight reel in the span of 4 seconds.
Oh, we'll see that forever this season. And the Holtby chant goes up.
What a way to punctuate a milestone game that's going to result in a victory. Braden Holtby, who has been outstanding start to finish, saved his best for last. The crowd continuing. They're not going to sit down again until this one is done. What a night for the Dallas Stars. The final seconds tick away. A hat trick for Hintz. Holtby and Bones celebrate milestones with W's. And the Stars have their fifth straight win, the longest streak active in the National Hockey League.
Well, one thing through the years, I've had great appreciation for our milestone nights that are memorable. And this certainly is. I saw Jamie Benn went over to get the puck. I'm not sure who's getting it, whether it's Holtby with his epic victory here tonight, 293 career wins now. He passes the immortal Jacques Plante on that list, or if it's Bones with his 2,500th game coached in behind the bench. What a night at American Airlines Center, and salute to you, number 70. Nobody's going to remember the blemish and the goal he surrendered.
39 saves the last three. Oh my goodness, put him in a time capsule. Roope Hintz, first NHL hat trick. Rick Bonus, a win in game 2,500. All Stars, what a night. They beat the Hurricanes 4-1. For Darryl Ray, Michelle McMahon, our terrific crew, I'm Josh Bogorod. Stick around, the postgame show is coming up next.